Greetings to you and welcome to Chidebere Media. As we commemorate the birth of the late Nelson Mandela on 18th of July this year 2020, I would like us to carefully go through this very speech which he made after he successfully fought apartheid in South Africa. Just cool down and go through this video and I shall be back. When I'm back, we shall carefully examine this video and see how it is connected to what is happening in Africa today. But before we proceed, please endeavor to subscribe to this very channel where we talk about issues affecting Africa and how we can make Africa a very wonderful continent that is good for us, good for our children, and good for the rest of our generation. Now let's get into it.
I have fought against white domination. Today, the majority of South Africans, black and white, recognize that apartheid has no future. Our march to freedom is irreversible. We must not allow fear to stand in our way. Universal suffrage on a common voter's roll in a united, democratic, and non-racial South Africa is the only way to peace and racial harmony. In conclusion, I wish to quote my own words during my trial in 1964. Today, as they were then. I quote, I have fought against white domination. And I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the idea of a democratic and free society in which all persons live together in harmony and with equal opportunities. It is an idea which I hope to live for and to achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
I have fought against white domination and have also fought against black domination. Those were the statements of Nelson Mandela, the greatest freedom fighter since the history of Africa. Nelson Mandela spent 27 years in prison while fighting against racial discrimination. He spent 27 years in prison while fighting against apartheid regime in South Africa, and Martin Luther King Jr. did the same thing in America. And even up to today, the world is still talking about racial discrimination. The world is still talking about racial discrimination despite the sacrifices these people have made. They went hungry, they starved. They lived in prisons, they did a lot of things, they paid a lot of prices to make sure that racial discrimination is brought to an end in our planet Earth. But it seems their sacrifices were in vain. And today, racial discrimination is still a top issue in our planet Earth. Today, black people are still being treated anyhow all over the world. They are being killed, and we have the Black Lives Matter protest rocking our planet Earth. And the big question is, what exactly is happening? Does it mean that people that were created by the same God, people that bleed the same red blood, and people that breathe the same air, that they cannot live together? It's a very big question which we are meant to answer. And again, it is a very big signal. It is a signal to Africans all over the world. It is a signal to Africans within the continent. It is a signal that we need to wake up and tell ourselves what we want Africa to look like. I don't see how possible it is for a continent that is the richest, a continent that is the richest in terms of natural resources. We are the richest. African continent is the richest in terms of natural resources, yet we are the most backward continent in the world, and we will still be expecting respect from the white people. No, I don't see how this is possible. So there is a part we need to play. We don't need to be blaming the white, but we need to make ourselves, we are the ones to work for the respect. And once we are able to make Africa what it's supposed to be before the eyes of the world, the respect we call. It is high time we wake up and tell ourselves what we want Africa to look like. We need to confront our leaders. We need to stand up for our rights. Africa belongs to us, and if we don't fight for Africa, it will still be like that until our next generation. And the same thing we are passing through now, our children will pass through it. And sometimes like this, when we talk about standing up to fight for our rights, standing up to fight for Africa, some will be asking some questions like this: how is it possible for us to stand up and fight for what belongs to us when you stand up and when you speak up, when you protest, when you speak against something you don't like, or when you expose something you see to be very bad within the system of government, the government will arrest you. Now, there is something we need to understand. People are getting arrested. People are being treated anyhow when they speak the truth, because we have left the struggle for a few minority. We have left the struggle for a few minority, and that is why they will jail, or they will try to jail anybody that stands up to speak against what exactly that is happening in the continent. We need to team up. It is not possible that everybody will come up and they can't arrest every citizen in the same state. It is not possible that the mass will leave what they are doing to come out to the street to protest, to speak against what the government is doing, and to arrest everybody and put them inside the prison. The reason why people are getting arrested, people are getting brutalized, people are being treated anyhow whenever they speak the truth, is because we have left the struggle for a few minority. And once they see that the people that have come up to speak against these things are few people, they have no option than to arrest these people. Like I said before in my past video, Africa did not suffer to get whatever they have today. The United States of America, they suffered a lot. They went through research, they did a lot of experiments. What they have today is as a result of their sweat, as a result of their suffering. They did a lot of things, spent time on research before they were able to produce what they have today. United States of America is well known, is known to be technologically advanced, and they are doing very well in technology. It's very rich, and they worked for it. The same thing with Europe, the same thing with Asia. But Africa here, we didn't suffer for what we have in our continent today. We have our natural resources, huge of them. We have them in large numbers, and we didn't suffer to get all these things. These are the things that God gave us. They gave it to us free. We just came and we saw all these things. Then the question is, what is holding us back? What is holding a black man back? What is holding Africa back? We didn't suffer to get all this. God has given them to us freely. What we just need to do is to make proper use of them and build Africa. This is the only thing and nothing else. Instead of our politician to be taking care of the citizens, developing the country, and doing everything in a way it would be to the advantage of the citizens of the continent, instead of them doing all these things, they are using it to enrich themselves. They are siphoning money abroad. They are packing the money and saving it for their children, for their grandchildren, for their great-grandchildren, and suffering the mass as a result of this. And this is something we must fight against. If we don't fight against it, it will continue. That's just the truth. It will not stop. It can't stop. It's not possible that it will just stop on its own. No. Somebody needs to fight against it. And who are the people to fight against it? We are the ones. They are not the owner of the country. We are called citizens. Citizens of this country. And the country belongs to us and not to any politician and not to any president and not to any governor. And these things will continue, and they will continue if we don't stand up to fight against these things. Now, there is something we must understand. Yes, it is also we get this very fact. It is not going to be easy because there must be saboteurs. In this journey of trying to liberate Africa from the mess it has found itself today, there must be saboteurs. Yes, there must be people that will go to the federal government, collect money from them, and be working against the mass that actually need change. They will claim to be working for us, but they will be working against us. They will go to the federal government. The federal government will bribe them, and they will be working against the people that actually want a change for themselves. So we should always be ready to see this kind of people. They must come. After all, Benjamin Boronbo said, "Each time I want to fight for African rights, I use only one hand because the other hand is busy trying to keep away Africans who are fighting me." Yes, I love this statement very well. I love it very well. It makes a lot of sense. I love it so much. I love the statement, and I love Benjamin Boronbo also because he was a very smart man. So if Benjamin Boronbo was able to observe this, that each time he wants to fight for African rights, he will not use the two hands, but he will use only one hand, and one hand will be busy pushing away African, not even Westerners or white people that are fighting against him, but African, fellow Africans that are fighting against him. So we should always expect saboteurs, and these people must come. But what we need to do is to be able to identify them. What matters is if the population of those that actually need change is greater than the population of saboteurs, there's nothing to worry. We have conquered. So what matters is for the population of those that are actually working for change. If the population of those working for change is greater than the population of saboteurs, there is nothing to worry about. So we must always expect saboteurs, but no matter what they do, we must conquer and Africa shall be liberated. I don't want these things to happen. I don't want this particular thing I want to talk about now to happen, but I think it's good we use it as an example. Yes, it's good we use it as an example, and at times we need to reason from that perspective so that it will be able to reveal to us the amount of responsibility that is up to Africans. And what I want us to reason is this. Imagine if all African Americans are deported today. As you mean, they say, if you know you're an African American, you're a black American, we don't want you in America again. Go back to your continent. Assuming this kind of thing should happen today, do we have a continent that is good enough for these people? Do we have a continent that when these people come to, they'll be happy enough to stay in it and not they won't have any need again to say, I want to go to America? Of course, we know it's not so. It's not so. If this kind of thing should happen today and they step their feet on Africa, no, they will say no, we are going back to America. They will say it is better we stay in America and they're oppressing us. It is better we stay in America and their police, their law enforcement are treating us anyhow than for us to stay in this continent and be experiencing this kind of thing. So these are the things we need to know. Nelson Mandela was a great fighter. He was a great fighter. The greatest freedom fighter in Africa since the history of Africa. Martin Luther King Jr. did the same thing in America, but up to today, we are still witnessing racial discrimination, and it's a wake-up call to we Africans, and we need to stand up and fight against it. So thank you so much for watching this video, and together, me, you, everybody, and all Africans located anywhere in the world, we're going to make Africa a continent that we, our children, and our generation to come will be proud of. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please do well to share this video to your platforms, to your social media platforms, so that it will get to more people. And at the same time, consider subscribing to this channel, where I will be bringing you lots of issues. We'll be talking about a lot of issues affecting Africa, how we can actually solve those issues, and how we can make Africa a very wonderful continent for us and for our generation to come. So thank you and bye for now. See you again in my next video. Thanks and bye for now.